Hey guys, welcome to Top 1%. In today's video, I'm going to answer your question on whether cardio is needed for fat loss. I'll get to that in a minute, but before that, you need to understand the absolute basics when it comes to burning fat. And that is, you need to be in a calorie deficit if you want to burn fat. If you do everything else right, and still you're not in a calorie deficit, everything you did just went in vain, because you're not going to burn fat without being in a calorie deficit. Whew, now that I've hyped up calorie deficit so much, let me simplify it for you. What does it even mean? The food that you take is energy, and the exercise that you do and your metabolism, your body functions, all of that, that burns energy. So if you eat lesser food than what energy you spend, you're in a calorie deficit. You're going to burn off fat. That's one way of burning fat, by eating lesser food than what exercise you do, right? So in that case, you're going to burn fat. And I've made videos about that in the past. I'll link it in the description. You can watch that after this video. The basics about controlling the quantity of food that you eat, eating enough fruits and vegetables, enough fiber content, eating lean protein, controlling the quantity of carbohydrates and fats. That's the basics of how you can control your diet to be in a calorie deficit. But in today's video, however, I'm going to talk just about what you can do to spend more energy. If you spend more energy than what you eat, you're going to be in a calorie deficit altogether. And that's what today's video is about. So let's get right into today's video. Without any further ado, let's get started. Now, don't get me wrong, burning off a few extra calories by doing cardio can definitely help you stay in a calorie deficit, which means you will burn fat. But you need to understand one thing. You saw the thumbnail of this video, cardio or diet? The answer is both of them. Both of them are absolutely crucial if you want to lose fat and keep off that extra weight forever. If you want long-term results, you need to have a basic structure for your diet, have some basic self-discipline. That's the only way you're going to get long-term results. No matter how much cardio you do, you cannot outrun a bad diet. For example, if you eat one pack of French fries, it's going to take you about 4 hours of cardio to burn it off. Oh, and that's excluding the ketchup, cold drinks and main course. If you include all of that, you'll probably be putting on fat even if you do cardio every single day. That's how important diet is. And once you get your diet right, you will lose some of that initial fat. You will make some progress for sure. But it comes to a point where you still have some stubborn fat. Some people have it in their belly, some people have it in their lower body, some people have it around their chin, right, the double chin. And if you want to lose that, you can't keep cutting calories forever, alright? What happens is, when you keep cutting calories, it comes to a point where your energy levels drop, you start feeling more tired, you have more cravings, and you don't feel good. So don't cut calories drastically. You need to be in a calorie deficit of about 300 to 600, no more than that. Any more than that, you're risking all of those side effects of having way too little energy, right? So that's something you need to avoid. And that's exactly when you need to introduce cardio into your routine and help yourself burn off a few extra calories so that you can be in a calorie deficit. In simple words, cardio helps to increase the rate of fat loss and at the same time allows you to eat more food so that you don't get much cravings, you're satisfied with your diet, and you can continue making progress. So cardio, it's definitely a great tool to have. Now, coming to cardio, there's two different types of cardios. One is low intensity steady state cardio and the other one is high intensity interval training. With low intensity steady state cardio, I'm talking about walking, cycling, or going on a treadmill, cross trainer, whatever it is. Anything that is low impact, that is comfortable enough that you can do it for hours together, honestly, but you're not pushing yourself that far. You're just doing it for 30 minutes, 45 minutes, 1 hour in a day. I know that sounds like a lot, but it's just basic low intensity stuff, right? So that helps you burn off a few extra calories without it interfering with your weight training. You don't get exhausted. You're not beating yourself up. Your joints are not getting beat up. So you can do that every single day throughout the year for the rest of your life. That's not going to be an issue. Now that's a sure shot way to burn off those few extra calories and be in a calorie deficit. So I definitely recommend you try low intensity steady state cardio. And this is something that even beginners can do. You don't have to be somebody that's athletic. You don't have to be somebody that has a very high tolerance for pain, or you don't have to suffer, right? So low intensity steady state cardio, that's the way to go for most people. Now there's another way to burn off fat, that is high intensity interval training. Now this is not for beginners. It's really a lot more painful, a lot more challenging for your willpower, because you're going to be pushing your limits. This could be sprinting as hard as you can, doing high knees, jumps, mountain climbers, burpees, stuff like that, high intensity stuff, that's gonna push your heart to its limits. your heart is going to be pounding like a machine gun, all right? So it's not for beginners. It's also going to have some effect on your joints, because let's say you weight train 3 to 5 days in a week. That's the way you should be doing it if you want to gain muscle, gain strength. And to lose fat, that's where you're doing cardio, right? So doing weight training on top of it, if you want to do high intensity interval training, there's no way anybody on the earth, there's no way anybody can sustain doing that every single day. You can't do HIIT every single day of the week. At most, you can probably do it 2 times or 3 times per week, but it's going to have a fatigue factor. It's going to get you worn out a little bit. So definitely include HIIT in your routine. If you're not a beginner, if you can handle it, go for it. There's nothing wrong with it. I like to do it. I like to challenge myself from time to time. But limit it, all right? It's not the be-all and all to burn fat. It has a positive boost to your metabolism, so that can help. But HIIT, less than 2 times per week, along with your weight training sessions, and that's the way to go. So to summarize, weight train 3 to 5 times per week. It doesn't necessarily have to be weight training. You can do body weight training, anything where you're stimulating your muscles to grow, to get stronger. That's what you need to focus on. And the second thing to burn off fat is to be in a calorie deficit by dieting the right way, having a basic structure to your diet, and also doing cardio, either low intensity or high intensity. The choice is yours. As long as you do that, you're guaranteed to burn off fat. All right. It's just a matter of time. You need to be patient. Burning fat and keeping it off for a long time, that takes time. It takes patience. So you may have to do this for weeks and months together, and over time, you are definitely going to see the results. Trust me on that. Be patient, keep working. And that's it for today's video. If you enjoyed it, hit the thumbs up button. Comment down below what content you want me to cover in the future. Share this video to your friends who want to burn off fat. And subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon. And that's all I have to say in today's video. Until next time, take care, stay hungry.